One of the big stories still making headlines this morning is the relief effort from Saturday's earthquake in Haiti.
If you're wondering what you can do to help, then this next interview is for you. The country just got hit by a tropical depression last night, if you can believe it. Carl Henri Petitfrère works for the Save the Children Initiative, which is helping families through humanitarian aid. He is down live in Haiti, and he is joining us this morning on Breakfast Television. Carl Henri, good morning and welcome. Thank you for doing this, sir.
Good morning, Jordan. Good morning, Daniel. And thanks for having me this morning.
Carl Henri, first question. You're in your car right now. I understand there's a reason for that. Please explain.
The house to which I was is a bit broken, and I would say destroyed a bit because I couldn't stay in. It was shaking very much. And after all, the storm arrives, and yesterday I see water in it, and I just could take a t-shirt and go outside and stay in the car. In the car, it's risky, but I'm obliged to stay in. But some people don't have a car. They just are in the street under the storm, and they don't have any tent. And also their houses are destroyed. And I think it's for the very first time I see that, because I was there in 2010 in Port-au-Prince. It was weird, but it wasn't that difficult. And at this time, I think that this country needs for real help from many people all over the world. And if they can support, they can help, it should be the time. Because I can say that I'm a bit emotional right now, because I see children, I see moms, I see dads in the streets, but they don't have the best way to protect themselves. And you know that we have a kind of lack of resources right now, and we need support, we need help from people. So the children inside try to support some families by giving blankets, some batches to create tents. But I can say that some organizations try their best, but it's not enough to rescue these people who are suffering right now.
Carl, can you describe for our viewers what it looks like on the ground in Haiti around you right now following last night's storm? Because I imagine the damage was so severe to begin with, and this would have only added to that. What are the new challenges Haiti is facing?
What I've seen on social media from local journalists, and we have floodings in southeast. And in the south, if you can see to the windows of the car, it's windy. We have the windy right now. And these people who are in some houses, but they were obliged to enter again. But we have some earthquakes, and it's keeping like shaking. So the situation is worse. It's worse from time to time. Then now I think that we try our best, but ourselves as humanitarian, we have to protect ourselves too. But in this moment, it's very difficult for us to be in the streets and help, because we are at risk, but we try our best and we're gonna continue. But as you can see, many houses, spaces are destroyed, and people don't have exactly where to stay. And also some hotels which would be able to receive people, they are not really standard, they don't respect the standard anti-parasismic stuff. So we just have to keep on helping. But some centers that we have, they are not ready to receive everybody. It's really difficult for us. It's raining at the same time. We cannot go into the houses. It's exactly what it is. But I think if many people all over the world can see this, it's a kind of nightmare. And now, if any help can come and support these people in the south and also in other parts of the country, in Lenape and also in Jeremy Gundens, it should be very important, because we have many dead bodies on the houses. We don't have all the things to ensure that we just extract them. And it's really important that we try to do something. But it's very difficult right now at this moment that I'm talking to you.
I mean, Carl, the number right now is 1,300 dead. Officials do expect that, unfortunately, to rise. We're literally looking at you from inside of your car, because there's not a safe building for you to sit in while you talk to us. And we can see the trees blowing through your car window as a tropical depression rolls through days after this event. What is, one last question for you, Carl. What is the message? We've shown the places where Canadians can help. What's the message you want to get out to Canada and, quite frankly, the rest of the world right now? What do we need to know?
And I know that Canadians are always friendly to us, and the same way that we have served this country during so long, because I have read through history that we have some doctors who were there, physicians who were there to support Canada, and we have a great community over there. And I think that it's now to an opportunity to continue to share hope with this country. And it's not a game right now, it's really serious. And if they can do anything to support, it's welcome. And I just can say that now, myself, I try to keep my hope, but I'm reflecting about children's lives, about mom's lives, people who have passed away, and families who are now in a kind of trauma. We really need the support from Canada, from Canada's nation. And I think now we can keep on creating hope, because it's not something that we can play with. If you are ready to support in any ways, please just donate and ensure that you support organizations which do their best to support. For example, we know that Save the Children, Plan International, and other agencies are doing their best. If you can support to them, do this. If you can support the government, do this, because everything is not really clear right now, evident in the way that we have to do this. But we try our best also as Asians, but other people who come, we say welcome, and please help the people who are in need of water, of food, and also some tents where they can go and stay and protect themselves.
Carl-Henri Petitfrère is from Save the Children. He is joining us live from the ground in Haiti, the site of Saturday's 7.2 magnitude earthquake that has left at least 1,300 dead. We anticipate that number, unfortunately, to go up. We've shown the charities and the addresses plenty. If you can help at all, Canada, please. It's an amazing community. They need our help. Please help them out. Carl, stay safe. God bless. And let's talk again soon. Thank you, sir. Thank you for everything you do.
Thank you so much. And I hope that we're going to keep our smile, even though the times are really difficult. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Carl. Again, if you can do anything, please hop online and give if you can. More BT after this.